In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add 3D objects into Photoshop and make them look super realistic. We'll cover how to match lighting, apply quick color correction, and even turn your static scene into a cinematic video. This is a powerful technique if you want to keep your subject consistent across multiple scenes. And the best part, you don't need heavy VFX software to pull this off. You can create cinematic visuals using just Photoshop and a few AI tools. So let's dive in. So a few days ago, I watched this video on Runway's YouTube channel, where they showed off a really cool technique. They used a 3D model of a fighter jet and rendered it to look hyper-realistic using Runway's reference tools. It looked amazing, but when I tried it myself, I couldn't even get close to what they showed. In every result, the composition was completely random and didn't match my reference jet image at all. So I decided to take a different approach and do it in Photoshop instead. And surprisingly, it was super easy. Here's how. First, you'll need Photoshop Beta and Substance 3D Beta. You can download both from the Beta app section in the Creative Cloud app. Now, I'll open Photoshop Beta and create a new canvas. For this first example, I'll be using a 3D model of a fighter jet. You can grab models like this from a site called Sketchfab. They've got a huge library of 3D assets. Just one thing to note, when downloading a model, make sure to get the GLB file. That version comes with textures already applied, so you won't have to deal with any extra setup later. After downloading your 3D model, just drag the GLB file into Photoshop. If you get an error when importing it, make sure the Substance 3D viewer is open in the background. That usually fixes the issue. All right, now that we have our 3D model imported, we need a background for the scene. For this, I'm using Midjourney, but if you don't have access to it, you can use any other free AI tool to generate a background. You can always create your own background from scratch, but if you're low on ideas or need inspiration, try using Midjourney's search tool. Just type what you're looking for. In this case, I'll search a fighter jet in the sky. Midjourney will show you hundreds of images generated by other users. The best part? Many of these images already have the right lighting and composition to match your 3D model, which makes the process much easier. So just pick and download the image that fits best. Or if you want to put your own spin on it, you can recreate a similar one with your own prompt and creativity. Once you've got your background image, just drag and drop it into Photoshop. Now, I want my jet to match the same position as the one in the background. So to do that, I'll double-click the jet's thumbnail to open it in Substance 3D Viewer. If you've never used this app before, let me quickly walk you through the basic controls. Right-click and drag to rotate the object, use left mouse button to move it, and use the scroll wheel to zoom in and out. You'll also see all the controls listed on the bottom bar for quick access. Now I'll go ahead and position the jet model to match the angle and placement in the background image. It's really easy once you get the hang of it. Sometimes when you reopen your 3D model, you might run into a weird issue. The pivot point ends up on the edge of the model, which can mess with your controls. To fix this, just click the reset button and everything will snap back to normal. Once the model's in the right position, the next step is to match the lighting. Head over to the Environment tab. This is where you'll find all the lighting controls. But before adjusting anything manually, click on Presets and choose one that best matches your scene. For example, I'm working with an outdoor scene, so I'll select the exterior preset for a more natural outdoor lighting setup. If your scene is indoors, go with the Studio preset for softer, indoor-style lighting. And then there's the Atelier preset. It includes multiple light sources and can work for both indoor and outdoor scenes, depending on the overall mood you're going for. Try experimenting with each preset to see which one fits your scene best. It's the fastest way to understand how each one behaves. Now, in my case, I'm going with Atelier because I was getting better results with it. After selecting your preset, you'll see two main options, brightness and rotation. You usually don't need to touch brightness. You can tweak that later in Photoshop for more control. But rotation is super important. First, take a moment to understand the lighting in your background image. Look at the shadows and highlights. Where is the light coming from? In my case, the light is coming from above and slightly behind and to the left of the jet. So I'll adjust the rotation slider until the shadows on the 3D model match the lighting in the background. Once I find the right angle, the lighting on the jet starts to feel a lot more natural and integrated. There are a few more useful lighting tweaks I'll cover in the next example. But for now, click Export to Photoshop, and the updated 3D model will appear back on your Photoshop canvas. Now I need to remove the original jet from the background image, and for that I'll use generative fill. Just select the area you want to remove and in the prompt bar, type remove. Alright, with the background cleaned up, our scene is almost done. Depending on your composition, you might want to add some motion blur to your subject to make it feel more dynamic. Just go to the filter menu, then blur and select motion blur, and adjust the value until it looks right for your scene. Next, do some color correction to make everything blend better. You can add adjustment layers, or quick method is to group all your layers, duplicate that group, and then merge the duplicate. Once that's done, apply the camera raw filter for final color correction. Tweak the exposure, contrast, shadows, and highlights to give your scene a more cinematic finish. And here's the final result. Now remember, you don't have to match your subject's position exactly to the original background. Feel free to experiment with different placements and compositions to create the look you want. Alright, here's another cool example. Let me break down how I created this scene. First, I imported this 3D model of a specific car. Then, I created a police chase scene in Midjourney and brought that background into Photoshop. To position the car correctly, I opened the 3D model in Substance 3D Viewer. I used the car and the background image as a reference and carefully adjusted my 3D model to match its angle and placement. Now, right here, you'll see this rotation option. This is a super useful tool. Sometimes you won't get the right perspective using just the orbit controls because the app doesn't give you full control over every axis. That's where the rotation setting comes in. It gives you extra flexibility to fine-tune the angle and get a more accurate match with your background. Then, in the environment section, I adjusted the lighting. I selected the exterior light preset because it matched really well with the overall vibe of my scene. After that, I fine-tuned the brightness and rotated the light to match the direction of lighting in the background image. This part is all about precision, so take your time here. Small adjustments can make a big difference in how realistic the final image looks. I also enabled the ground plane option. This automatically creates a shadow beneath your subject, which really helps with realism. But if you prefer to create your shadow manually in Photoshop, you can disable it. And that's it for the setup in Substance. Now, let me show you what I did next inside Photoshop. First, I used generative fill to remove the original car from the background image. Then I noticed a weird blank space on the left side window of the car, probably due to lower quality in the 3D model. To fix it, I simply duplicated the layer, and that patched it up. Next, I created a layer mask to erase the original shadow. It looked too harsh and didn't really match the movement of the car, and especially in a fast-moving scene like this. To create a more natural-looking shadow, I duplicated the car layer again, applied a Gaussian blur, and then masked out everything except the shadow beneath the car, which gave me a much softer, more realistic result. Now to make the wheels feel more dynamic, I wanted to add radial blur. But because the 3D model's wheel quality wasn't great, I decided to use the rims from the background car instead. It's a simple trick. Just make a selection of the rim, copy and paste it, and then use the transform tool to position and resize it precisely onto the 3D model. Lastly, I cleaned up some fringing on the wheels and around the car body using the paintbrush tool for a clean finish. And that's it for this part. Of course, you can color grade the final image to match your scene. Adjust contrast, tone, shadows, and mood however you like. You can also go a step further by adding extra effects like dust, smoke, water drops, or light flares to bring more drama and realism to your scene. Now, to turn these still images into a cinematic video, you can use Luma AI. I've added a direct link in the description. They recently introduced a camera control feature, which is super useful and gives you much more flexibility with how the camera moves through your scene. As you can see, there are plenty of advanced camera presets you can explore, perfect for anyone experimenting with AI filmmaking. Here are a few clips I generated using Luma AI with my own images. And as you can tell, the camera motion looks super realistic. They also added a new reframe feature, which lets you extend the borders of your videos and change the aspect ratio, similar to how we upscale or extend images. That can be really handy in a lot of creative scenarios. Alright, now it's your turn. Go explore these tools, push your creativity, and start building some truly awesome visuals. If you found this tutorial insightful, make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.